Hey everyone, it's Eric from MAPerformance.com. In this video, we'll be doing an install of our auxiliary fuel system for the Ecoboost Mustang. If you found yourself here without this kit, a link to the product can be found in the description below. This is a pretty complicated install, so we're going to break it up into three parts. We'll take you step by step all the way through. Part 1 is assembly of the kit. Part 2 will be connecting the lines, and part 3 will be wiring. This fuel system allows for auxiliary fuel injection, allowing for more fuel and higher horsepower. If you want your Mustang to be able to push up towards 500 wheel horsepower, this kit is right for you. So if you don't have one, pick one up. If you have one, let's get into the install. Before we start installing, we have to relieve all the fuel pressure. Remove the back seat lower cushion. On the fuel pump connector, slide the little red tab and pull the gray clip off. Crank the car and let it run until it dies. And disconnect the battery. Moving on to the install process. Disconnect the factory fuel line. Remove the small metal clip. Take the quick disconnect tool and remove the line the rest of the way. If you're having trouble removing the fuel line, make sure the disconnect tool is clicked in fully and pull on the tool outwards. Unplug the fuel pressure sensor. On the back side of the sensor, there's a white clip. Press it in and remove. Next, pull off the fuel sensor. 12 millimeters on bottom and 24 millimeters on top and twist. Save this for later. Screw the fuel line sensor onto the fitting. We recommend using liquid Teflon tape. We used AN blocks and a vise to make sure the fitting was properly secure. Lube the factory fuel line and click the fitting into place. Lube the line on the high pressure fuel pump and click the next fitting into place. Remove the throttle body harness. Remove the charge pipe by unscrewing the clamps. Set it aside. Remove the 4 8mm screws from the throttle body. And remove the fuel rail from the throttle body. This kit comes with 4 5mm Allen bolts. Take the O-ring side and attach it to the throttle body. Hold them together with one screw and hand tighten all 4 bolts. Then secure all 4 bolts fully to 89 inch pounds. Plug the throttle body back in. Remember to slide the red clip forwards. Lube the O-rings on the new injectors. Plug them into the new fuel rail. Slide them into the throttle body and tighten the bolts to 89 inch pounds. Next up, grab the pressure gauge and apply liquid Teflon. Screw onto the top of the fuel rail. Lube the O-rings on the dash 6AN cap and fitting and screw into place on both sides of the fuel rail. And reattach the charge pipe. Take the old fuel pressure fitting and attach to the new dash AN fitting. Tighten the two together. Attach these two fittings using liquid Teflon and then screw the other fitting on. Attach the short line to the fitting. Snap the fuel pressure line onto the factory fuel line from the fuel tank. Snap the short line to the high pressure fuel pump and tighten. Attach the long line to this fitting on the fuel rail and tighten. Attach the union adapter to this fitting assembly. Leave this one loose until it is attached to the car. Attach the next fitting. Attach the short line onto the car. Connect the two dash 6AN lines to the Y fitting. Make sure everything sits properly and tighten down all fittings fully. Finally, plug the sensor in. Now that the fuel lines are all set up, we will move on to wiring. You can mount the adapters anywhere you want, but in this video, we'll be mounting it on the battery housing. Sort out the wires and begin with the two black wires, which will go to the ground. Run these to the negative side of the battery. Tape them together and cut to length. Strip the ends and twist together. Attach terminal and shrink wrapping. Attach to the battery and secure. Next, sort out the two red power wires and run them to the fuse box. Tape them together and slide over the wire sleeve. We use Waytech brand. Next, we will attach the add-a-fuse. Cut and strip the wires accordingly and twist together. You can use crimp fittings, but we recommend a solder joint. Prep the wires and solder the add-a-fuse to the wire. Slide shrink wrap to finish the connection. Next, the brown and green wires will go to the ECU. tape them together and attach the wire sleeving. Shrink wrap both ends, cut and twist together. Attach the protective spade terminal and crimp to both brown and green wires. We will come back to this later. Next, we will pull the top connector plug off the ECU. Push down on the top black tab and pull the gray lever back to release. Cut the zip tie and press the gray lever forwards. Use a pick or other tool to press the two tabs down and remove the black cover. Crimp the two red T-tabs onto these ports. Attach the brown wire here and the green wire here. Clip the black cover back on and zip tie to secure, and then plug back into place. Run the wire along the factory engine harness. Next, remove the fuse box cover and pull fuse 40. Add it to the bottom slot of the ATA fuse we attached earlier. Add the 7.5 fuse and add it to the second slot. Plug the assembly back into slot 40 and close the cover. Next up is deciding where to run the injector harness. We recommend you run it alongside the OEM harness to keep it away from hot engine and turbo parts. We used zip ties to run it securely along with the harness. Don't tie it too tight to avoid pinching the wires. And that's it. You just installed your MAPerformance auxiliary fuel system for the 2015 EcoBoost Mustang. Hit the road today and enjoy. But before you do that, be sure to drop this video a like. Let us know how the install went in the comments. If you have any questions, let us know below as well. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel for many more installs, unboxings, and tons more cool stuff. If there's anything else you want to see, just let us know.